My name is Dirk Biemens, co-owner of InnerGrow Greenhouses. We are a greenhouse tomato grower located in upstate New York. We were established in 1998, started in Allegheny County, New York, where we have 15 acres of greenhouses. Over the years we've grown up to 70 acres. We grow a variety of tomatoes, beefsteak tomatoes, cherry tomatoes and tomatoes on the vine. Our main markets that we supply is in Northeast United States, so we go mainly to New England area, New York, Washington DC, Baltimore area. Our customer base is probably about a 600 mile radius from where we are located. We use different sustainable practices. For example, we capture all the roof water that falls on the greenhouse and we use that for irrigation. All the water that we feed to our plants is recycled. So we pretty much have a 100% closed system. In the wintertime for heat, we use natural gas and biomass. So we have 10 megawatts of biomass boilers that we use wood chips. And the secondary fuel is natural gas. We capture the CO2 from our boilers that we feed into the greenhouse. This gives us an increased yield. Due to the increased demand of our customers to supply year-round product, 2 years ago, we installed artificial lighting at this portion of this facility. We have 8,585,000-watt lights, to be exact, that are powered by grid and CHP. The total demand is about between 9 and 10 megawatts. 8 of those are produced by the grid and the balance by our CHP. We capture the CO2 and the heat from the CHP installation. The CO2, again, we use that in the greenhouse and that gives us an increased yield. And the heat, we use that for heating the greenhouses. When we decided to go to artificial grow lights, at that point we knew that grid was maxed out, the capacity on the grid at 8 megawatts. We didn't want to do any concessions on the intensity of our lights, so we wanted to stay with the desired intensity. So we needed to get some extra electricity in here, and that's when we decided to install a cogeneration plant in addition to power from the grid. We installed a 2.4 megawatt Jenbacher engine. We run it island mode currently for our lighting, and our lighting season typically is from October through April roughly. Lights are on around midnight and they stay on for a maximum of 18 hours a day, so by 6 in the afternoon the lights go off again and the plant shuts down. Well, the electricity comes on automatically, so as we get a demand from our climate control system that the lights are going on, the cogen automatically kicks in. When it's up to temperature, then we can start using the exhaust for CO2 delivery into the greenhouse, and we capture the heat from the exhaust system as well. The electricity we use for one section of the greenhouse to power the lights, so completely island mode. The heat we use, we store that in a heat storage tank and we use it at nights when it's cold or during the day. The immediate benefit for us is the fact that we have artificial lighting and year-round production that some other companies, due to infrastructure problems, are not able to do. Our reason for choosing this solution was installation. So the system arrived in, as you can see here, a container shipment, which is, so the whole engine is built in overseas. Everything is inside here, so it's a relatively easy commissioning of the system. And right away the container is sound insulated, so not much sound outside of the container.